We're just about to leave for a flight over Milford Sound. Here's our little plane.
And Sean is the man.
There's Honey Ben. Who's our pilot?
Sean.
Where are you, Sean?
Sean's the guy who hasn't started to shave yet.
I think he's already in the plane.
Okay. Our pilot.
Oh yeah.
Do you have any reason to?
Hold it. Hand up this one. And we'll move all these seats forward once we get going, so we have
okay.
Heaps of leg room there.
Just down the side, you will find the seat out. They work just like the airline.
Quite a nice little airport, Wanaka Airport. Got lots going on here. There was some skydiving going on a little while ago. People were coming down from a flight. So we're gonna have a lot of fun here. Little Cessna 185 Skywagon. and a half cruise on Milford Sound. And it's just incredible here. Steep, steep sided. The sound, I don't know how deep, but it's a long way. As you can see by the look of the mountains either side, glaciers many years ago swept us clean of all soft stuff and gravel. Cover the mic and see if I can get it. This is beautiful. Hey, Ben. Are you freezing? I'm getting some stills of that. Turn around, we'll be facing the entrance to Milford Sound, but you won't be able to say anything because the wind will be so loud in the mic. Finally turned around and we're heading downwind now back into the fjord. A lot calmer and warmer in the sunshine. This fjordland gets about 200 days of rain a year, so today there isn't a cloud in the sky, so we're very lucky to have this kind of a clear day.
We're just coming up to the entrance really back in the Milford again. Point now on the left hand side. There's a shallow bench across here. It's a thermal moraine. The depth is only about 260 meters. And we don't have to go very far back into the fjord before we're back to a depth of 1,000 feet again, or 300 meters.
1,000 feet
now, deep. Milford is one of 14 fjords that comprises the Fjordland National Park. 1.2 million hectares, 3.5 million acres of it. It's the northernmost fjord. It's probably the most dramatic to sail into, but by no means is it the largest, or by any means is it the most beautiful. It is the only fjord, though, that has a road that leads into it.
You don't like this very much, do you, huh? Thank you. Battle of the cameras. A few seals here, apparently.
On that rock, I think.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. They look pretty small.
They don't like California seals, huh?
No. Sorry.
I don't know if they're just pups or a very small species of seal. They're quite a bit smaller than the ones we see in California, though, on the West Coast. Pretty happy looking little campers, though.
Coming up towards the Sterling Falls. We saw them from the other side. Now we come right in fairly close to the base of these, so if you're outside, do mind your cameras, a bit of spray will come back. They're 154 metres high, just over 500 feet, with equivalent height to a 50-storey building. Now there is no lake up there, it's just ice and snow melting that makes it one of our permanent waterfalls. Point, this opens up Harrison Cove, and Harrison Cove, the only place in the whole fjord that you can safely anchor a vessel. It is the only place that's shallow enough. So when the early Europeans here, the sealers, this is where they came to seek shelter from storms and the Tasman to pick up fresh water. As we come around a bit further, you'll see a structure in there to the left of us, and it's known as the Underwater Observatory. And this gives people a place to go down beneath the water and have a look at the coral that grows here. In a fairly natural state. You see here in the fjordland we have black coral growing in very shallow conditions. It's due to the freshwater layer. Also, as we come across a bit further, you'll see to the far left Mount Pembroke at 2,000 metres. It was named after Pembrokeshire, the shire that Milford Haven is situated in Wales. As quickly as they start, they also finish, usually within about an hour of the rain season before the waterfall.
That poor little guy is getting photographed all over the place.
Do you see him?
No, I don't.
William was left buried in 1894. If you have your own transport, there is a beautiful walk out to the base of the falls, well worth doing. Then ahead of us, the Sheerdown Range, and up to the right-hand side is where the Milford Track comes down, if you're interested. This is a beautiful walk, takes 4 days from the top end of Lake Tiano to the fjord. Of course, prior to 1953, was one of the very few ways of getting into Milford, so I battled around the coast by boat. And then ahead of us, the channel leading back into the harbour. With the channel in view, it marks the end of the trip, down to the Tasman return. On behalf of the Rainbow Cruises, on the South of Rock, thank you for joining us today. Good opportunity.
Say something, honey.
Hello, everybody. Hi, kids. Not going to believe
here
I'm
we go.
Doing this.
going.